Hello friends, welcome back to Pharma Biomed. Let us move on to our next tutorial. In this tutorial, we discuss about National Library of Medicine, which is a very important tool for the students of pharma, medicine, as well as healthcare sciences. National Institute of Health, NIH. NIH is a world's biggest medical research center. And it is a part of the U.S. Department of Health and Human Services. And the NIH is the largest biomedical research center in the world. Under NIH, National Library of Medicine will operate. Coming to the NLM, NLM is the world's largest biomedical library. NLM is a part of NIH under, again, U.S. Department of Health and Human Services. And it is located in Bethesda, Maryland, USA. You can see the web page, the home page of National Library of Medicine. Coming to the few more details of NLM, it has several million books, plenty of the journals, technical reports, manuscripts, microfilms, photographs, and images on medicine, pharma, and other related sciences. The current director of NLM is Patricia Flatley Brennan. So coming to the various resources at NLM, the first one is Medline. So Medline is a bibliographic database of life sciences and biomedical information where the citations and references of all the scientific work that is done towards in the field of pharmacy as well as medicine and healthcare sectors will be collected and stored here. And it is a data bank of medical literature where you can analyze the medical literature and where you can retrieve whatever the literature support you want in the field of pharma as well as medicine. And particularly it is useful for the students of medicine, nursing, pharmacy, dentistry, veterinary medicine, and all healthcare sector. Then the next one is PubMed. So PubMed is a free search engine which is easily accessible to get the information related to the database references which are already stored in the Medline, as well as the abstracts in the field of life science and abstracts in the field of all biomedical topics. It is a free search engine. You can see the homepage of PubMed. Then the next one is the National Center for Biotechnology Information, that is NCBI. So this NCBI is also part of the NLM, that is nothing but National Library of Medicine. This NCBI is a house of all biological databases where you will get the information about the genes, genomes, protein structures, ESTs, coding sequences. So it is a hub of all the biological databases. And one more important feature of this NCBI is NTRES. What is this NTRES? It is a federated search engine or nothing but it's a web portal where you can get the information about all the biological molecules by retrieving or taking the information from various databases, and it also operates under the NCBI. And another resource of this NLM is a toxicology and environmental health resources, where it gives an information system for all chemical emergencies, the responses against the chemical emergencies, as well as the education we have to imply to the public, the public education strategies. So here the different databases are there. Among them, the very important one is the Hazardous Substances Data Bank, that is HSDB. It is a toxicology database, which basically contains the information related to the potentially hazardous chemicals and how far they are harmful to the humankind and what are the preventive measures to be taken against the usage of these hazardous chemicals and whatever the guidelines that has to be followed at the level of industry, all these will be given in this particular data bank. Now we move on to the official webpage of this NLM and where we can see the different services offered by the National Library of Medicine. This is the official website of National Library of Medicine, where you can see different services provided by National Library of Medicine, product and services. So here PubMed and Medline are there. Already we have seen the PubMed and Medline. Here you can type any of your research of interest and any of the topics, so that whatever the work that has been done already in that particular area is available to you. So here you can see around 32 million citations for biomedical literature from Medline, and all life science journals are, and as well as online books has been given in the PubMed data bank. And coming to the other resources we have here is the next one. You can see MESH. This is also very useful platform for the medical students as well as pharma students, where you can get the information related to the different terminology which we use in medicine and pharma and healthcare by just searching in this particular portal. This is called Medical Subject Heading 2021. So this is one more very important resource we have. And the other one is this Medline Plus. So where you will get the information about various health topics, drugs, supplements, and the genetics underlying the diseases, the information about the medical tests, and very explanatory videos and tools will be available in this Medline Plus. So these are the different services that are provided by the NLM, and there are plenty of the resources are available for each category of the learners, such as researchers, publishers, librarians, educators, healthcare professionals, and as well as the public. And you can explore NLM to the library by applying to them, and by through proper channel, you will get the access to the National Library of Medicine, by which all the professional community will be benefited. And then the grants and funding, where the grants they are going to provide to assist the research programs, that also being given. That is also one of the service that is provided by this National Library of Medicine. So on the whole, this is a very important platform that everybody who are in the pharma, healthcare, and medicine, they have to access this portal to get the latest updates in their particular domain, so that they will be acquainted with the current progress that is going to happen in their particular fields. Thank you. I think this is a very brief glance of this particular information. Further, in next tutorials, we will try to explore how we can access and how we can retrieve the information from various platforms. If you have any queries, just post in the comment section, so that I'll try to answer to those questions. Thank you, one and all.